And the band played on. When you attend a fifth grade band concert, you don't expect to hear a skilled performance. Beginning instrumentalists generally shriek and squawk like blue jays. However, Dale Penley, Jefferson Middle School band director from Oak Ridge, Tennessee, is an experienced director who knows how to get the best sound from his students. He uses innovative ideas to motivate them to practice, such as scheduling an annual parent band concert. By teaching parents to play their instrument, student skills are reinforced, and parent skills, or the lack of them, are exposed for the entire world to hear. Because Tylan's mother had no time to practice with him for the concert, he begged me to participate instead. "Please, Grandma," Tylan's brown eyes welled up, and my resolve melted like a Hershey bar as I reluctantly agreed. Tylan opened the velvet-lined black trombone case and showed me the basics of assembling the trombone, including how to empty the spit valve. He demonstrated how to hold the trombone, blow into the mouthpiece, and move the slide. Then he showed me some exercises to loosen my lips. Next, he retrieved his Essential Elements band book and played the first tune, Rolling Along, also known as Mary Had a Little Lamb. Now it was my turn. When I blew into the mouthpiece, it sounded like a cow bellowing in pain. Mary's Little Lamb was doomed to become Mary's Big Lamb before I mastered the song. Tylan's patience soon ran out, and we only practiced two more times before the concert. On the Thursday before the big night, Tylan brought home a note from Mr. Penley that listed 20 songs parents should be prepared to play during the concert. I had only learned to play three notes, G, F, and C, and hadn't even conquered one song. 20 songs? I began to hyperventilate. The Tuesday night at the concert, I entered the cafeteria of the high school with Tylan and discovered only a few parents were actually participating in the parent band. Most of the group had played in high school or college bands and were experienced musicians, although a bit rusty. The parent band included three men on trumpet, two women on clarinet, and one woman on percussion. I was the only trombonist. There was no way to hide in this small crowd. By now, Tylan was as nervous about my performance as I was. He wouldn't even pass me his trombone so I could warm up. "You don't play it right, Grandma. I don't want my friends to hear you." "Too bad, Tylan. Mr. Penley is counting on my playing with the parents, and I'm going to do my best. Hand over that trombone." Like a flock of sheep, we followed Mr. Penley on stage. The parent band sat down on metal chairs in a semicircle in the front row with the student performers behind us. Several hundred spectators stared back at us from the auditorium. "Please, God, let everyone drown me out," I prayed. Mr. Penley waited as we placed the band books on our music stands. Then he announced the song and page number, raised his baton, and we were off. I stayed off the whole time, like a racehorse that never left the gate. I blew and tooted the trombone every time I saw the notes G, F, and C. The rest of the time, I faked it and moved the slide up and down. Sweat trickled down my back as we ran through our repertoire and finished with our finale, Lean on Me. By then, I was more than ready to lean on someone. Except for my discordant notes, the parent band sounded quite good. Relieved the ordeal had ended, I handed Tylan's trombone back to him for the student band performance. "Grandma," he whispered, "you weren't moving the slide at the right time." I patted him on the shoulder, knowing my performance had been a disappointment. As I walked to my seat, several people complimented me on my playing, and one even invited me to play in a brass quintet. Obviously, I'd fooled some people, but I knew I hadn't fooled Mr. Penley, and I certainly hadn't fooled Tylan. For my grandson's sake, I had attempted to conquer the mighty trombone. The trombone won.